Hello everyone, this is Phil Maturano. Welcome to my home studio in New York. And this is my review of the Odery Air Control Snare Drum. Air control system all about? It's the design that lets you control how much air comes out of the drum after a stroke. Okay, so you get to control everything. Give you a little close-up here with this knob. Alright, this knob controls the apertures that are in the drum. There's four apertures. There's one, two, three, four. Okay. And with this knob, you can control the amount of air that comes out, right? So there's halfway closed and there's fully closed. Now you can, once you have your setting where you want it, you can just tighten the screw and it holds there, okay? So open it all the way. So what I'm gonna do is take the top drum head off and show you inside the drum exactly what's going on. So let's do that. Okay, so I've taken the top head off so you can see how this works exactly. And you have one layer here, okay, one hoop. And then you have the bottom half of the drum. Now, you see inside how this layer turns inside. It's very well crafted. It's very well imagined, if you will. So you see the apertures opening there and closing. All right, there's this ring inside that slides like this. So it's a very ingenious and something that I'm personally really digging because it gives me a couple of choices with sound. Okay, as you can see, the actual width, there's a lot of plies, right? A lot of plies in the snare. And that also gives a really good sound. Like if you want a classic rock sound, the depth of the drum helps you achieve that, okay? But it's also versatile if you put, a hoop crasher on it or a little splash cymbal. It also gives you really nice, really super modern kind of a sound, like for drum and bass or whatever funky thing you want to do with it. So that's how the system works inside. Now let's talk about the sound a little bit. I'm going to put the head back on and let's talk about the sound. Okay, we've got the head back on. Now I just want to talk briefly about what you can do with this or what this can do for you. So if you go on the Odery website, it's going to give you some graphics, which I'm going to pull up here. So if you close the apertures, right? With the apertures closed, you get more of a compressed, drier sound, okay? Now, you're gonna feel that actually when you play, all right? When you play, you actually feel that it's like a bit more rebound that you get, okay? Now, if you open the apertures, that lets, of course, all the air out as you produce each stroke, right? So the rebound is gonna be affected by that. You know, this is minimal stuff we're talking about, but what's very interesting is the sound, okay? The way the sound changes. Now when you open it like this, now the apertures are open, you get more of a, let's say, if the drum was made out of metal, okay, it's definitely more open. You can tell the difference when you get used to hearing this drum, okay? At first it may not seem like it's a lot of difference, but then after your ear gets used to it, you go, wow, okay, yeah, that is different, man. That's very different. So you can, you know, actually choose to put it in the middle too to get a happy medium between the two sounds. Personally, I like, if I'm playing like rock, I've had this snare for about a week and a half now, and I've been doing a couple of different gigs with it. If I'm doing like funky stuff, I like to keep it open. If I'm doing more classical stuff, I like to keep it closed. Even like for jazz, maybe I like to keep it closed. And you know, pop and rock, pop stuff, I keep it somewhere in the middle. You just have to experiment and do whatever you want with it. Now, I don't know if my Zoom Q8 camera is going to be able to, if you're going to be able to tell the difference on there. I'm going to give you a little sample. This is wide open, okay? Get an idea. Don't know if it's going to come through on the Zoom, like I said, but it's very useful when you want to have a couple of different options for sound. All right. Now, what else can I tell you about this drum? Well, another thing I like about it is that it's obviously very well built, and it has the optional, you know, of course, this feature here where you can put the snare strainer on either side or whatever side you happen to be working with, however you want to. Okay, so that's pretty handy. And it ships with these snares, and it ships with Evans heads. Obviously, heads are gonna have an impact on your sound. You have to choose, you know, what sound you want out of your drum heads. The overall finish of this drum is absolutely beautiful, okay? It's really, really rocking the craftsmanship, and the finish is stunning. If you can give a little close up there. The finish is really, really nice, and everything is superbly built, I must say. Okay, I've seen a lot of snares in my days, and this is, you know, right up there with the top of the top, man. Really, really fine craftsmanship. I think you'll be very happy with this drum. So, as a primary drum, it's fantastic for rock, pop, you know. As a secondary drum, I have a drum, a snare drum on the side, and I use two snare drums a lot, you know. As a secondary drum, it's also fantastic. You can put a hoop crasher on it, like I mentioned before, or a splash cymbal, and get a really modern, you know, super hip sound. Or you can go for the classic rock sound, okay? So, remember, on the Odery site, you can see a little more about this snare drum. All right, another thing that I find really nice about it is that it sounds real precise. The response is gorgeous, and it has a warm, to me here as I'm sitting in the front of it, has a really warm, special sound. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that. Now let's have a listen to it on the kit. And if you have any other questions about the drum, please write me. I'll be happy to answer any questions. right, that's my review of the Odery Air Control System Snare. Beautiful instrument, and I think you'll really dig it. Okay, see you on the next clip. Ciao.